everyone, Jessica Whitaker here. I am a New York City based photographer, and today I'm going to be running some numbers with you on why is photography so expensive. I've done a video on answering your assumptions about photography and photographers, and if you would like to watch that video, I'll have it linked up on an iCard. I thought we'd dive into the specifics today just to educate the general public, the consumer, our clients, on why we charge what we charge and essentially the costs of doing business. Because at the end of the day, we as photographers are not making the full profit of what we're charging for a session. Now, of course, a lot of this gear and software that I'm gonna be sharing with you can be written off in taxes because we are running a business here. However, the money we're making, regardless if we can write it off or not, does go back into the business and not into our pocket. Having a higher profit margin will determine how much you will actually be able to make and profit from your sessions, but this video isn't on pricing your photography. That, if you're interested, is all in my online photography workshop. I have about a six or nine part chapter in pricing your services right, no matter where in the world you're located, because I do believe that we as photographers can target our dream ideal clients in our own backyard. It just takes strategy. So I'll have a link to my online photography workshop down below. I have four categories we're going to be working through today for the general cost of doing business, and I've split it up into two groups of people: full-time photographers and part-time photographers. Before we hop into the video, I do want to thank Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. Skillshare is an online learning community for creative professionals with over 25,000 classes in design, photography, business, marketing, finance, and so much more. Right now on Skillshare, I'm loving the class Bookkeeping for Freelancers. It's taught by Emily Simcox, who is an industry professional, as are all of the classes on Skillshare. And it's a 10-part class. A review on her class reads, "This was the missing link between the real world and my college accounting class. I'm so glad that I found this course." Premium membership for Skillshare is about $10 a month, and it gives you unlimited access to all of these classes. Join more than 7 million creators on Skillshare today. You can use the link in my description box below to get access to 2 months of free premium membership, and this is not an affiliate link. Support my free videos here on this channel and your creative career by signing up down below. Let's hop into the video. There's four categories we will be working through today. I have all the numbers here on my computer for both my full-time photographers and my part-time photographers. Everything I'm sharing is from a place of love. That's just how I teach. I really believe in educating the consumer, but not from a place of entitlement or from a place of being snarky or sassy, because how can I expect somebody who has never picked up a camera before to know everything that goes in the business? It's not my client's job to know all of these numbers. It's not. But it is part of my job as an educator to share these numbers and to teach from a place of love. The first question was, how much have you spent on your current camera and lens setup? This is everything relevant to your business right now. Even that tilt shift lens that you pull out for one or two shots during a session, if you use it with your clients, include it in this rate. So, for my full-time photographers, the average cost was $10,500 in their setup, and the highest being $20,000. Now, for my part-time photographers, the camera and lens setup average was about $4,000. As you can see, there's like a $5,000 difference, and I think a big reason for this is usually full-time photographers will have two or even three camera bodies, and if you're doing, for instance, wedding photography full time, chances are you have invested in specific lenses for specific shots, whether that's a macro lens for ring shots or a really like a 135 or an 85 millimeter lens for bridal portraits. So that is why I think that there is quite a big gap, as you can imagine. Next category is the most boring of all. How much have you spent on all the other camera gear and accessories that clients don't really know about. The things that are not fun to spend our money on, such as backup batteries, solid state drives, external hard drives, tripods, SD cards, bags, all of that stuff. And the average cost for my full-time photographers was $5,000, while the average cost for my part-time photographers was $1,500, which does make sense. The more time you spend with clients and behind your camera, the more you are going to spend on all that additional gear. I mean, just think about it. If you are doing photography full-time, how much more hard drives are you going to need to store all those files in the backup systems versus somebody who's doing photography part-time? It's gonna be like halved, right? So the third category was, how much do you spend on software and web services in total a year? This can be reoccurring monthly expenses or one-time purchases. For instance, this could look like your website template, your website host, your domain, custom domain host. This could be your client management software, the Adobe Suite, presets, video editing software, your email. There's so much that can go into this alone. The average cost for my full-time photographers yearly was $3,000, while the average cost for my part-time photographers yearly was about $400, which you can see is a pretty big gap. But again, it does make sense considering full-time versus part-time, the amount of images, the bandwidth you're going to need, and the extent that you will be marketing yourself. The last category is the most important and also the most interesting to clients out there who are watching. Time. I presented the scenario of, how much time does it take for you to complete a 2-outfit, 1-location standard portrait package? Now, this could be one individual or a couple, like an engagement session, but 2 outfits, 1 location. From the moment that you receive that initial inquiry, all the back and forth, of course, the time spent on the session with your client, the editing, the delivering of images, and then all of the follow-up that goes back and forth once the images have been delivered. The time that goes into it for both a part-time photographer and full-time photographer is relatively the same. The average was 10 hours for full-time photographers, and the average for part-time photographers was 8 hours. Isn't that so interesting? For this kind of session, it wasn't super surprising to me, a standard portrait session. Now, 10 hours is still a lot of time. Now, there are ways to be able to shave down these hours a bit, to even go from 10 hours to 8 hours and just save a little bit more time behind your computer screen communicating with clients. And I teach how to do that all in my online photography workshop. But the time aspect is the most important, in my opinion, because time is priceless. If I can spend more time in front of my camera on the session with my clients versus behind my computer answering questions that could easily be consolidated, I would prefer that. Even if it means I'm still spending 10 hours on a complete session, if more of that can be in person with my client, I would much prefer that, because that's, in my opinion, a little bit better customer service, right? More of an experience. If you wanna learn how to craft that experience, definitely check out my online workshop. Again, it's linked down below, but regardless, you can see that it takes about the same amount of time, whether you're full-time or part-time, with the client on the session and all the before and after. And I dive more into the communication and the reasoning and, you know, why is it really 10 hours? That seems like so long. I answer those basic questions, not necessarily how to cut back, that's all in my workshop, but why it does take time, that's all in my video on answering the assumptions about photography and photographers, which I have linked in an iCard above if you wanna watch that. I hope that this video helped anyone who is curious about why is photography so expensive. And of course, expensive, that term is going to be relative to depending on the individual looking at the pricing, but just for the sake of the ease of the video, the expensive term was used. But I hope that this gave some insight into the work behind all that goes into photography and the numbers, the cost of doing business. Thank you again to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. I really recommend those photographers out there watching, or those in any kind of creative career, to go and sign up for that free trial. There's no credit card required. There's no affiliate link. I don't make a commission off of you signing up. It's just an amazing way to be able to support my channel, but so that you can also support your creative business. Be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more free photography tutorials on a weekly basis. And if you enjoy my free resources here, you're also going to love my Instagram, where I pour into your business on a daily basis through Instagram Live, stories, Q&As. I love being able to kind of have that more one-on-one interaction. And of course, my online photography workshop is linked down below. I love you all. I believe in you, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.